Hi, this is Dr. S. Rafi Ahmad, working as an associate professor in the Department of Physics, MIT University, Chennai. Now we are going to just discuss about a topic. It's from Engineering Physics 2 for the second semester. So the topic which we are going to see here is crystal physics. So first of all, we have to know what is a crystal. So the crystal is nothing but a solid material. A crystal is a material in which the atoms are oriented in the regularized fashion. So here we are going to study the properties of the crystalline materials. So in general, there are many crystalline materials. So from that many materials, we are going to consider one type of material, that is a primitive material. Primitive material is nothing but a material which contains only a single type of an atom. That is, we are going to see today lecture. My topic is crystal physics. So in crystal physics, we are going to deal with simple cubic structure. Okay, students. Before going to the exact structure of the material, first we have to know some introduction about the material. So in general, we know that materials are brittle, malleable, ductile. Some of them are a good conductor of heat and electricity. Some of them are a bad conductor of heat and electricity. Some are seems to be a magnet. Some are seems to be a non-magnet. So these types of the materials are made up of atoms and the molecules. So as generally we know that a material which constitute of the atoms and the molecules. So here in the crystal, so these atoms and the molecules are held together by the force of attraction. What is this force of attraction? So this is a force of attraction is nothing but an internal force which makes the atoms to bond together. So this is the introduction for our topic, crystal physics. Okay. So next is the classification. So classification is nothing but a type. So generally there are two types of the crystalline materials. So one is a pure crystal and another one is the impure crystal. So this is a pure crystal is called as crystalline solids. These impure crystal are called as non-crystalline solids. So these non-crystalline solids can also be called as amorphous solids. So what is this crystalline solids? what is this non-crystalline or amorphous solids. So we have to distinguish the differences between these two. For the crystalline solids, let consider a material solid. As we know, this is a solid material consisting of n number of atoms. When these atoms are oriented in the regularized manner, then such type of the crystals are called as crystalline crystal. There should be some regular repetition, there should be some equal interval between these atoms. When there are some equal repetition between these atoms, then such types of the material are called as the crystalline material. So let consider amorphous. So here in amorphous, when the atoms are not oriented in the regularized manner, then such type of materials are called as amorphous material. See here, I have just drawn a structure in which I have taken atoms. So here we are having a different types of the atoms. See, these atoms seems to be in a smaller one. So when compared to these first atom, the second atom seems to be in a larger. So when we are not having a equal atoms, when we are not having the same atoms in the material medium, then we can call such a material or as a non-crystalline or as the amorphous. So here sometimes holes also will take place. Okay students, so these are all the just introduction for our base material, that is a simple cubic structure. Next, there are many types of the crystalline material for example our consideration simple cubic is the first form of the material. BCC is the second material. FCC is the third material and HCP is the fourth material. So here I have shown four different types of the materials. So from these four different types of the materials, the first material, it's called simple material. Because here we are having only one type of atom. That is, the material medium contains only a single type. So it's called as simple material. So this is a simple material is nothing but we can in general called as pure material also. The rest of the materials which we are shown, BCC, FCC, HCP, so these all are non-simple material, because in which we have more than one type of atoms. That is, example, we can say that so this is the unit cell. So I have taken a unit cell. So this unit cell contains corner atoms. If the material medium contains only the corner atoms, then such type of material are called a simple cubic material. If the material have an additional atom more than the corner atom, then such type of material are called non-simple materials. So I have shown an example. So this example is nothing but suitable for BCC structure. So like that, we have to distinguish FCC and we have to distinguish HCP. This is the just third parameter type. So once again, students, just I am going to revise what we have seen before strike out this. First is our introduction. In introduction, we have taken a material. That material is nothing but a solid. In general, we know that the solid materials are brittle, malleable, ductile, good conductors of heat and electricity, bad conductors of heat and electricity, magnetic, non-magnetic, and so on. So these materials are made up of atoms and molecules. So these atoms and the molecules are present inside the materials, are bonded or joined together with the help of the force of attraction. The attractive force which held together the atom, it's called bonding. So these we have seen in the introduction. Next, classification. So here in general we are classifying the material into two, crystalline and the non-crystalline or an amorphous. Crystalline materials are the materials in which the atoms are oriented in the regularized manner. When the atoms are oriented in the regularized manner, then such type of material are called as crystalline material. When the atoms are not oriented in the regularized fashion, it shows that when the atoms are missing inside the structure, when the atoms are just increased more than one inside the structure, then such type of material are called as amorphous materials. And finally, types of the crystalline materials. So these parameter types is based on the presence of the internal atomic structure. So presence of the atoms, presence of the orientation, and the presence of the direction, we are classified these crystalline materials into four. SC, BCC, FCC, and HCP. So with this, we are just going to continue what is a simple cubic structure. So let's wait. Yeah, students. So we have seen the introduction, we have seen the classification, we have seen the types. Now is our objective. Objective is nothing but we are going to discuss what is a simple cubic structure. So this simple cubic structure is studied with the help of parameters. What is this, sir? What is this parameter? See, every material having some sort of properties, every material having some sort of the nature. So to know the nature, to study the internal structure of that material, we have to consider some parameters. So to study this simple cubic structure, in general we are going to consider four parameters. The first one is number of atoms per unit cell. So we can use a symbol N for this, capital N. The second parameter is coordination number. We can use a symbol for this, as a CN.
The third parameter is atomic radius R given by symbol, and the last parameter is atomic packing factor. In general, we called as APF.
So these are all these four parameters we are going to consider to explain the or to study the
structure of simple cubic crystal.
So let us consider the first parameter.
Number of atoms per unit cell.
What is this number of atoms per unit cell? So this number of atoms per unit cell is nothing but it is defined as
number of atoms present in or shared by the unit cell.
So this is the definition for the first parameter, number of atoms per unit cell.
It is defined as
the number of atoms present in or shared by the unit cell. Let's consider
an example. I have taken a structure . So this structure is a simple structure, simple cubic structure.
So we know that in simple cubic structure, the material medium contains only one type of atom, that is corner atom. So we have taken a structure, is nothing but in a simple cubic. I have taken a simple cubic unit cell.
So to study the parameters, we usually consider the unit cells.
We never take the exact structure, but we take only the unit cell. So I have taken a unit cell. This unit cell is for a simple cubic. So this unit cell contains only one type of atom. That too,
corner atom.
So these corner atoms are located at the
8 corners of the unit cell. So as we just are seeing that
these corner atoms are only at the corners. These corner atoms are not at anywhere. So these everything is at the corners. So these corner atoms are 8. So these are one type of an atom, primitive cell, only a specific corner atom, 8 corner atoms in a unit cell.
So these 8 corner atoms are shared with other unit cells also.
So this is the first parameter, number of atoms per unit cell. The definition for this is number of atoms present in or shared by the unit cell. To explain the first parameter, I have taken an unit cell, is nothing but a simple cubic unit cell. In simple cubic unit cell, a medium contains only one type of atom, that is a corner atom. We are having totally 8 corners, so the 8 corner atoms occupies that 8 corners. So if we consider any one atom out of this 8 corner atom, for example this one I am going to consider as a reference. So these corner atom, say reference atom, contribute or shared with 8 adjacent unit cells. So how we are going to just show these contribution, how we are going to say this corner atom is going to be shared with other 8 unit cells. So let's see the difference. So we have just discussing about the simple cubic structure. So we know the simple cubic structure is a material which contains only one type of an atom, so that too a corner atom. The first parameter is number of atoms per unit cell. So that first parameter, number of atoms per unit cell, is defined as number of atoms present in or shared by the unit cell. So to explain the first parameter, we have taken an unit cell and we just mentioned that that unit cell contains only a single type of atom, that too a corner atom. So totally we are having 8 corners, so there are 8 corner atoms in a unit cell. So we can just write the parameters also. This is the number of atoms n, defined as the number of atoms present in, the present in is 8, or shared by the unit cell, or shared by the unit cell. So we have to know the sharing, how this reference atom x is going to share with the other atoms. See, this is the first contribution. So I have taken a unit cell and I have just considered one corner atom as a reference atom x. So this reference atom is contributes with other unit cell. So like this, we can say it contributes to another one unit cell. And it also contributes to other unit cell. So we have just drawn the three-dimensional structure. We have drawn a three-dimensional structure of SC. So the contribution of this corner atom is to the first unit cell, to the second adjacent unit cell, to the third adjacent unit cell, for the fourth adjacent unit cell. So like this, it also contributes to the opposite side of the unit cells, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this one is just 1, so 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So totally these just atom, particular atom, say the reference atom, is contributes with 1 by 8 of the adjacent unit cells. So we can write number of atoms for a simple cubic structure, n is equal to 8 into its contribution. So we get n is equal to 1 atom. Yeah, students, this is the first parameter which we have obtained to study the crystal structure. I have measured what is n. N is equal to 1. So these be the first parameter. So as we know, to study the simple cubic structure, we are going to evaluate four parameters. First one, number of atoms per unit cell. second the coordination number, third the atomic radius, and fourth the atomic packing factor. So to find the number of atoms per unit cell, we know the definition defined as number of atoms present in or shared by the unit cell. So we have to know the present or the presence and the sharing of that reference atom. So to just explain the number of atoms per unit cell, I have drawn an unit cell. I have considered one corner atom. So this corner atom contributes with 8 adjacent unit cell. So with this I have given the conclusion. N is equal to 8 is a number, is the contribution 1 by 8. So N is equal to 8 into 1 by 8. So N is equal to 1 atom. So this will be the first parameter for the simple cubic structure. So like this, we can measure the parameters for the rest of the crystal structures also, BCC, FCC, HCP. So in future, we are going to see that. Now we just discuss what are the remaining parameters and we give the conclusion for this. Yeah, students, next. The second parameter is the coordination number. So this coordination number is given by the symbol Cn, is defined as the number of nearest neighbors, the number of nearest neighbors to the reference atom, say X. So this is a definition for the coordination number. The number of nearest neighbors to the reference atoms. Yeah, students, these parameters are very simple. The only thing is we have to know, we have to get an idea. So before we are going to write what is the atomic number, what is the coordination number, what is the atomic radius, what is the atomic packing factor. So to explain this, so once again I am going to consider an unit cell. So what I have drawn previously, that same structure, so here also I am going to consider to explain this parameter, coordination number. See, I have drawn, I have taken an unit cell. Now I am going to consider this corner atom as a reference. So we have to draw the contributions also. So as we know, already we have drawn. So this contributes to the second unit cell. So similarly, draw the third contribution, and similarly draw this last contribution. So we are getting an exact structure of the simple cubic. So we have taken a unit cell and we have taken these atom is as a reference atom. So for this reference atom, the nearest contributions is just we are going to write. See, I am going to draw the exact structure to define the atomic radius, sorry, coordination number. See, The points which I have mentioned here is the nearest coordinate points. So from these we can consider this one to define the coordination number. So for this point, for this corner atom, the nearest neighbors is 1, 2, 3, 4. So the coordination number, we can write coordination number as CN is equal to 4 atom in its own plane. 4 atoms in its own plane, 4 atom nearest. So this is the own plane. Plus 1 just above the plane, that is a reference, plus 1 just below the plane, that is reference. So students, it is clear that we can easily define the coordination number with respect to the principle as shown here, the number of nearest neighbors to that of the reference atom. So here I have considered these as a reference x. For these, the nearest neighbors is 1, 2, 3, 4 on its own plane, 1 just above and 1 just below. So here we can write the coordination number as 4 plus 1 plus 1. So it became CN is equal to 6. So we have measured the second parameters, that is CN is equal to 6. It's clear. I think it's easy to understand. So this is the second parameter. The 4 atoms on its own reference, 1 just above and 1 just below. So this is the second parameter. Let's see the third one. The third one is the atomic radius. The third one is the atomic radius. Atomic radius is defined as half of the distance, half of the distance between any two nearest atoms. Here is one condition, which have the direct contact, that we have to note, direct contact with each others. See, we are going to consider any two nearest neighbors, that nearest neighbors to touch with each others. So that's the condition. So to define this, once again I am going to consider the simple cubic unit cell. See, in simple cubic unit cell, as we know that an unit cell contains only 8 corner atoms. So these 8 corner atoms can be able to contribute with the 8 adjacent unit cells. So that's all we just know about the unit cell, to explain the coordination number and to explain the atomic number. Now, to study this atomic radius, other than this point, I am going to say that, so these corner atoms are a direct contact with each others. See, I have just considered first face. Let imagine A, B, C, D are the position of the atoms.
The same position here I am going to write. So these atoms are the corner atoms. So these corner atoms are having direct contact with each others. See students.
So here I have shown the unit cell. Here I have considered the front view of that unit cell. So here in the front view, these corner atoms A, B, C, D are having the direct contact, having the direct contact with each others. So with these, we can measure our third parameters. Let's see.
From the front view, I am going to consider only two atoms. I am going to consider only two atoms. Let consider A and B.
See these atom A and B is separated by a distance A. So this A is nothing but a cubic edge. You can call these as cubic edge. So this cubic edge is nothing but distance separation. So we have taken atoms, we have considered the first portion. So from this first portion we have taken two atoms. So let R be the radius of these atoms. So from these we can define the atomic radius as 2R is equal to A. From these we can write R is equal to A by 2.
Okay student. So we have measured the third parameter also. R is equal to A by 2.
So the only one parameter is the remaining to study the structure of simple cubic crystal. See once again I am repeating the atomic radius. Half of the distance between any two nearest atoms which have the direct contact with each other. It should have the direct contact with each others. So to explain the atomic radius, considered an unit cell, 8 corner atoms. So here in simple cubic, these 8 corner atoms are directly contact with each others. So I have given the front view. From that I have taken the two atoms which are direct contact with each others. So from these A is a cubic edge, distance separation, and R is the radius. So we can write 2R is equal to A. From these we get R is equal to A by 2. So this be the third parameter.
The last parameter is the atomic packing factor. By this atomic packing factor, we can conclude our concept.
Okay student. The last one is simply I am writing as APF.
So this APF is defined as, we are having a formula here. So volume of the atoms
to the volume of the unit cell.
So in simple way we can write APF is equal to small v by capital V. Here a small v is nothing but number of atoms per unit cell into volume of one atom. Volume of one atom. So here the volume of the unit cell is AK. So we can write APF is equal to N into volume of the one atom is 4/3 by R cube by A cube. So since we have the values for N and we have the values for A also. So from this we can write R is equal to A by 2. So substitute these values in the condition APF, we get 1 into 4/3 pi into A by 2 the whole cube by A cube. By simplifying this term, finally we get 4/3 pi A cube by 8 by A cube. So mathematically we can do some changes. So we can cancel this term, we can cancel this also, and finally as a result we get pi by 6. So these are pi by 6 is equal to 0.54. Oh students, so this is the final result for our topic. So with these we are going to conclude our concept. See, the atomic packing factor APF is obtained as 0.54. So conclusion, only 54% volume of the atoms are occupied by the SC unit cell. So remaining, I think 46% of the volume is empty. So this is the conclusion for our concept simple cubic structure. So in simple way, just I am going to narrate what I have taken. I have measured N, N is 1, I have measured coordination number is 6, I have measured atomic radius A by 2, I have measured atomic packing factor 0.55. So from the final conclusion, atomic packing factor, just we are concluded that only 54% of the volume is occupied by the SC unit cell, the remaining 46% of the volume is empty. Thank you.